let's consider the sequence 2, 7, 15, 26, 40, 57, and so on, with a sub 0 equals 2. By looking at the differences between the terms, express the sequence as a sequence of partial sums b sub n. Then find a closed formula for the sequence by computing the nth partial sum. So analyzing the sequence, notice 2 plus 5 is equal to 7. 7 plus 8 is equal to 15. 15 plus 11 is equal to 26. 26 plus 14 is equal to 40. And 40 plus 17 is equal to 57. So we want to write these terms as partial sums. To begin, b sub 0 equals a sub 0, and therefore b sub 0 is equal to 2. B sub 1 is equal to a sub 1, which is 7, but we want to express 7 as a partial sum. Let's write 7 as 2 plus 5. Next, b sub 2 is equal to a sub 2, which is 15, and we can write 15 as 2 plus 5 plus 8. So the corresponding terms are equal, but we're expressing the b terms as partial sums. B sub 3 is equal to a sub 3, which is 26, which we can write as 2 plus 5 plus 8 plus 11. And then b sub 4 is equal to a sub 4, which is 40, which we can express as 2 plus 5 plus 8 plus 11 plus 14. And now let's focus on the terms of these partial sums. Notice how we have 2, 5, 8, 11, 14, and so on. Notice how these terms are increasing by 3, and therefore this is the partial sum of the arithmetic sequence 2, 5, 8, 11, 14, and so on, where a sub 0 is equal to 2, and notice how the terms are increasing by 3, and therefore the common difference d is equal to 3. So if we can find a formula for the partial sums of this arithmetic sequence, that will be the same formula we can use for a sub n to generate the terms in the original given sequence. Let's work on this on the next slide. So again, here is the arithmetic sequence, and we want to find the formula for the partial sums. Again, the common difference d is 3 and a sub 0 is 2, and therefore a sub n is equal to a sub 0 plus d times n, which is 2 plus 3n. And now because we have an arithmetic sequence, we will use the method of reverse and add to determine the formula for the partial sums. And I've already set some of this up to save some time. We begin with the equation s equals 2 plus 5 plus 8 plus dot 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 plus, we know the last term is going to be the nth term, which is 2 plus 3n. The term right before this one is going to be 3 less, since the common difference is 3. Notice 2 plus 3n minus 3 is negative 1 plus 3n. Now we write the same equation in reverse order, where we have s equals the quantity 2 plus 3n plus the quantity negative 1 plus 3n plus dot 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 plus the last two terms are plus 5 plus 2. And now we add the two equations together and solve for s. On the left, s plus s is equal to 2s. We have 2s equals, and now all the sums on the right will be the same. Notice 2 plus the quantity 2 plus 3n is 4 plus 3n. And the next sum is also 4 plus 3n. 5 plus the quantity negative 1 plus 3n is 4 plus 3n. And we have plus dot dot dot. Again, the last two sums are also 4 plus 3n. So now the question becomes, how many 4 plus 3n's are we adding? Well, we're summing the terms from the arithmetic sequence where the first term is a sub 0 and the last term is a sub n, and therefore there are n plus 1 terms in the sum, which means we're adding n plus 1 4 plus 3n's. And therefore we can write the equation as 2s equals the quantity n plus 1 times the quantity 4 plus 3n. And now to solve for s, we divide both sides by 2. The formula for the partial sums of the arithmetic sequence is s equals the quantity n plus 1 times the quantity 4 plus 3n, all divided by 2. And since the terms in the original sequence are equal to the partial sums of the arithmetic sequence, The formula for the partial sums is also the closed formula for divisional sequence. So going back to the previous slide, we now know a sub n, the closed formula for the divisional sequence, is the quantity n plus 1 times the quantity 4 plus 3n, all divided by 2. The same formula for the partial sums of the arithmetic sequence. I hope you found this helpful.